So from your knowledge, could you tell me, you know, does much thought go into pairing these 25 kids with this teacher, or is it just randomly drawn?
No, absolutely. Much thought goes into placement. Those decisions usually begin in the spring of the previous year, and much consideration is given to balance the class in terms of boys versus girls, girls and boys, a mix of those, and also to have varied instructional levels. Also, if your class happens to have an in-class support teacher that is scheduled to be in a certain classroom for a specific amount of time to address the needs of specific students, they would be in that particular class. So there's a lot of information that goes into placement. And teachers usually work with administrators to make the best possible placement. They also know the personalities of the students. They also know what students get along with other students. And so they really try to make a nice mix in the class.
Would it go specifically for student to student, hey, Johnny here needs a teacher who can really discipline students? Would it go that way as well?
Yes, you're talking about teachers who have had these students really being able to have a conversation about what each student, what they see each student needs, and then matching those needs to the appropriate teacher for the following year.
Maybe a couple weeks before school starts, many kids get their new teachers in the mail, and just by having friends in older grades or just by hearing in the community, oh, that teacher is evil, that teacher is mean, and right off the bat, kids are scared to death to go to school, and they might even get in their parents' head saying, Mom, can we try to switch this teacher out? Or maybe the parent is interested in trying to switch. Is it even worth it to make that call?
Well, I always think it's worth communicating with the school. But I'll just tell you, myself as a school administrator, I really tried not to change placement just based on someone hearing about a teacher, or maybe even a sibling had experienced a teacher and the parent doesn't necessarily want their next child to have that teacher. But everybody has a different experience with teachers. And so because so much thought goes into it, I think the best course of action is you can give the school a heads up and tell them about your trepidations or, you know, what you anticipate, so that really that can be made known in the beginning of the year, and then work through that. I mean, it's really important to have ongoing communications with the school. You may find that some student heard something about and they're like, I don't want to go to that class. You may find that's the best possible teacher that your student could have and will gain, have great success that year. So again, I would trust what the school is saying in terms of placement, always leaving the lines of communication open. And if there's any trepidation, make that clear in the beginning, not necessarily asking to change, but these are my concerns. And they should be addressed up front by the administrator, the teacher assigned, and the parent, so that there is a comfort level with the student entering that class.